Hello, everybody. Scott Golden here with the Superstars of Wrestling series for the 14th of May 1994. Bret Hart interview talks about facing anyone he needs to from his brother Owen and defending the championship against whomever. He doesn't really care who it is. Then the intro package. Bret basically endorsing he's going to be a fighting champion all over the world. That's the whole idea here. We open then with a match with Quang. Quang not exactly getting over like gangbusters, although having decent enough matches as it were. Enhancement match time for Quang. Quang with several hard shots and chops and back kicks on his opponent. Getting things under the auspices of the way that Quang thinks they ought to go, and then hits a hook spin kick, and manager Harvey Whiffleman, complete with purple jumpsuit, is happy with the win there. There's a posters magazine hype for the upcoming release, and posters at the time seem to be something that the WWF's caring a lot about. Some injuries to Yokozuna. Earthquake being hyped up as a, I guess, opponent for Yokozuna in the upcoming weeks and months. Hype of Earthquake being able to out-sumo wrestle Yokozuna, and highlights of Earthquake in a sumo position, both in Japan and elsewhere. Is here, and we kind of set up the sumo style match between the two. Pierre of the Quebecers is out next, and his opponent in this particular contest is Mabel. Of course, this is the King of the Ring qualifier. Winner of this will go into the King of the Ring qualifier. Mabel takes early control, including body slams and the like, goes to the second rope on the inside and manages to go for and miss a big splash from that second rope. Attempts a body slam, does Pierre, but Pierre falls backwards under the weight of Mabel. And Mabel able to turn it around. Eventually get the splash to his advantage and get the victory. Oscar wraps his way out. We also hear more matches for the King of the Ring, Diesel and Bret Hart. Diesel, of course, the Intercontinental Champion. Bret Hart, the World Champion, so... that hype coming up. Sparky Plug and Bam Bam Bigelow in a qualifier for the King of the Ring as well. Lex Luger and Double J in a qualifier as well. And more hype on the continuation of the upcoming feud between Lawler, or one-off match actually, between Lawler and Roddy Piper. Thankfully not a feud, because I don't think it would have lasted very long or gone very well if it had been a longer feud, because their one match did not go well. Doink is in the middle of the ring here, around the enhancement match paradigm, and he continues with Dink at his side. Enhancement talent takes a couple of shots at Doink, doesn't get anything he wants on it, and ends up missing quite a number of shots. Dink manages to kick the enhancement talent takedowns by Doink, side headlocks, stump puller type maneuvers, dropping fist drops, and other... things there. Splash off the top from the Doinkster, and a victory for the lovable clown with the whoopee cushion style maneuver. We see a limo arriving. Limo driver is unbeknownst, but the Nikolai Volkoff, who had been commissioned by Ted DiBiase, is here and is opening the door to the limo for Mr. DiBiase, acting as a chauffeur, and DiBiase critical of him all along, basically saying that he owes him everything that's here. Anyway, AC Connor, which I believe is D'Lo Brown, in an early enhancement talent match with the Earthquake here. Earthquake, of course, headed on a series of collisions with Yokozuna for a little while before leaving the Federation again. Connor gets a couple of punches off on the Earthquake, but runs into a almost sidewalk slam, knock bottom type maneuver, and a sit-out splash by Earthquake after body slam and his normal Earthquake jumping splash, and Earthquake says he's going to take care of Yoko once and for all and be prove who is the best and brightest of the future of the WWF, I guess you'd say. Owen Hart here again and continuing to be week by week, I guess you'd say, one of the most favored talents of the day. I don't necessarily know that I would say where he is his favored, but it's here, and he manages to hit a, as I pick up a little extra sound there, as he manages to hit his victory and get that victory pretty quickly. Again, some inverted suplexes by Hart and other such things. More hype of the King of the Ring tournament as we go forward here. And without a doubt, King of the Ring is becoming a summer tradition. We finally do see Nikolai Volkov in his former U.S. and Russian flag run-ons, but managing to get some punch kick basic stuff behind his aggression here. Tie up, hip toss, and the like by Volkov. Volkov managing to get a couple arm drags, and at this point, fans are kind of split with him, but because he has DiBiase, they are booing him, and Volkov cranks up on the headlock. DiBiase is tired of being embarrassed, and he is trying to invigorate his man from ringside, basically imploring him not to embarrass him further. Irish whips by Volkov, misses a clothesline by a million miles to the back of the head, the Russian sickle style, and gets a victory here. The garbage man, a.k.a. Duke the Dumpster Drosy, gets another highlight, says he's going to take the trash out of the WWF. Yes, this is the time for that angle, and highlights of IRS being absconded by Scott Steiner from last week, and the involvement of Tatanka is here, setting up the Tatanka and IRS program. Enhancement talent match, and Tatanka is taking a couple of extra hard chops at his opponent after a back body drop and a suplex, hip toss and the like, and the Samoan drop by Tatanka for the victory here. Tatanka kind of lost through the next few months before turning heel in the summer of 94, and we close the program with more highlights from the house show circuit. Jeff Jarrett says he wants another match with Sparkplug Bob Holly as we close the program. We'll be back with more right after this.